Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. So today I'm going to be playing Zero-G Racer Antigraviator. This was developed and published by Iceberg Software and retails for a price of $15.99 and was released on October the 30th of this year. So what I'm going to do is jump straight into the Novice League in the campaign mode. Let's see if it's any good, shall we? I've done a bit on my mixer stream and it's very, very fast. So if I do go quiet, it's literally because I'm trying to concentrate on the track, as it is unrelentlessly fast. You can see the graphics are really nice, you know, the smoke effects, the tracks are well illuminated. But you're going at such a speed where the only thing you're focusing is trying to get ready for B, in all honesty. My mixer run of this campaign, I finished third, but I got off to a terrible start and then picked it up towards the end, and hopefully I can get in the top four here. Got a bit of work to do now though, mind. One thing is, especially in this game, there's such a fine margin for places. Literally, first to fourth is literally a couple of hundredths of a second. It's a bit like Formula One in terms of speed. You can press A to boost and the left stick to barrel roll. And you can use traps, but I personally haven't found them very useful so far. Well, that's not what you want to do. Kind of reminds me of a Star Wars pod racer on the Dreamcast back in the day. Last game I was good at this that I was good at as a kid was Hi-Octane on the Sega Saturn. That was really going back. Didn't do very well on that one. Hopefully we can do a bit better on this race.
Get ready! 3, 2, 1, go!
Oh.
again, the graphics are really good. Just going at a speed that you can't really appreciate them. Track a tad easier than the other one. It's a little bit more streamlined as opposed to the other one, which had a lot of bends in. And this, as long as you don't crash in the middle bit, you'll be in the places. Third, I'll take that. Right. If I get a win, I should be able to take the lead, hopefully. This is the one I did pretty well in last time, so let's see if we can win, shall we? Again, beautiful graphics, sort of like a futuristic city vibe going on. One does seem the easiest of the three tracks so far to get the hang of. Only really a couple of tight bends in the middle. can split past, but... trying to fire rockets to slow me down, but they ain't stopping me the first place this time. No, I'm having a lot of fun with this one. I can say it's definitely not one you could play in large doses though. I'll say that it's very well optimized for the speed that you go, you know, there's no stuttering, no lag. It's very good in that aspect. Right, took first place on that. So that leaves me third on the leaderboard. As long as I have a good round here, I should come first. I'll say this is probably the prettiest of the maps I've seen in space with a view of the Earth. Stunning. I need old Alpha to get eliminated so I can take first place. Good. seconds in sight. Oh, Kappa's down. And take the competition. Second. Ah, he would be the guy that finished above me, was the one that survived. So, a 1-2 wasn't enough there. Doing very well on the first race. Got me there, unfortunately. Extended League is Titanium League as well. No, there's a lot of features, you know, there's hangars to upgrade your ships. Tons of features there, lots of wings, planes and everything. Do a quick race in all the locations. So you've got polar caverns, space islands, forest levels, and a practice area. Overall, would I pay £59.5 for it? Yeah, you know what? I probably would actually. I quite enjoy like Wipeout Pod Racer, so I recommend picking this one up. Anyway, if you did like this review, please like and subscribe for future videos.